farm, so I'm here sleeping on my lemon tea. I have been having one very long day. Yeah, so yesterday I went to Mbagathi, Kenya, and took the AstraZeneca vaccine. The AstraZeneca vaccine is from Oxford, if I'm not wrong. For the longest time, because of the conspiracies, the story about how the world is overpopulated and people are trying to reduce Africans, the thing about becoming not getting children and they want to get like three children, and also the fact that we've never gotten a vaccine for a virus, and also we don't have any DNA vaccines for now apart from the COVID-19 vaccine. So I don't know why I decided to go take the vaccine because my mom is so against it. Like, watch the video, she'll be so worried. But mom, I'm okay. And yeah, I'm okay, I'm doing fine. So I got the vaccine yesterday at Mbagathi. Where else can you get the vaccine? You can get it from Kenyatta or KUTRH, but the last time I checked at KU, it was out of stock. In Kenyatta, it was running out of stock, so they limited it for their staff. So right now, Mbagathi, the requirements is that you should be a health worker or an essential provider, like a teacher, and also over 60. If you are over 60, you have your ID card, fine. If you have your practice license for the medics, good to go. If you can prove that you're a teacher, also good to go. So the process does not even take 10 minutes. It was so fast, and we're out of there. It's not painful. I fear needles, and that was not painful. But after that, you get like a swelling and you get like a swelling and your arms becomes like really painful, and the side effects. So I have been having a flu for the last few days. So when I took the vaccine, I think it wasn't because it had like two different things or pathogens in the body, so it was bad for me. I went back to work. Initially, I didn't feel anything, but when I got to work, I started getting a headache, a very bad headache. So I took PCM, then paracetamol, then I was so sleepy, but during the day I was like okay. When I got to the house, it got bad. I got fever, I was sweating, I was feeling cold. So I took mara moja, and I was fine for a minute. Then I went back to getting fever, and at night I was sweating profusely, and in the morning I had nausea. So apart from fever, headache, dryness of the throat, nausea, those are the side effects that I had. But my friend who took the vaccine with her, she did not get any side effects. So I think it reacts different with different bodies. So I know my mom is not for this, but I took the vaccine. And if anything happens, I was not forced into it. If I become a vampire, guys, don't kill me. If anything happens, it just happens. I won't pretend I'm okay. I am a little bit paranoid when I hear that, oh, they finally stopped vaccine in their country. I'm like, okay, I have that thing in my body and there's nothing I can do. I can just sit and wait for the results. But the reason I took it, when you look at it gives you 60% protection, which is better than zero. Also, it will prevent the disease from progressing to the worst it can be. So you have like mild conditions and you get the COVID-19, and I just took the vaccine. So you do just do your research. I'm not here to convince anyone to go and take the vaccine. If you want, do your research, go take the vaccine. If you don't want, herd immunity also exists. Yeah, just think about it. I know it's confusing, but when you think about it, come up with a decision. Takua tupoa. Yeah, remember to like, subscribe, leave a comment down here. Let's get to the other subscribers. Guys, keep safe, wear a mask, sanitize. I work in the hospital. I have seen COVID patients and it's not good. Just learn to live with it because it's not going anywhere. Unless we have a vaccine, yeah. we can eradicate, but before then, keep safe.